All right, welcome to the third, it's October 31st, it is our third year of Movember, and this is, as per tradition, like in Canada, the traditional welcome to Movember, the month of Movember video that John and I make, right?
Well, yep.
Great. John wanted to be an idiot and wanted to set the mood, so as his idea, John wanted to light a candle, because... an idiot. So what are we doing here, Jan?
Well, so at the beginning of Movember every month, as is tradition here in Canada, and we're not in Canada, that's a South Park reference, as we've done over the last 3 years, and as part of the rules of Movember, we need to shave at the beginning of the month, and so Ryan, being the only one here who can actually grow facial hair,
a couple days stubble,
is going to shave in just a few moments, but Ryan's going to explain a little bit about Movember, and then I'm going to share with you some ways that you can make sure that your fundraising is as effective as possible.
So you might be thinking, like, what's Movember? Why are you guys shaving? What are you, stupid? Like, what are you guys doing? Why do you have a weird t-shirt going on? So Movember is a nonprofit, and it's a really, really popular thing as of late, especially in Whitewater, Wisconsin, with a couple of cool guys. but it is an awesome worldwide men's health advocacy and fundraising organization. And it's something that we've bought into for 3 years now, and it's something we really support. And so basically throughout the month of November, which is now recalled Movember, men who want to participate grow mustaches on their face to spark conversations. Those conversations lead to advocacy about men's health. So that means getting your annual checkups. That means getting yourself tested for things like prostate cancer, which kills 1 in 7 men, for heart disease, for mental illness, all this kind of stuff. When you look at men's health, there's a lot of focus on breast cancer. Well, prostate cancer and other sorts of men's cancers are just as deadly. If not more, and they are much underfunded. So Movember's here to help fix that. And so those conversations kind of lead towards donations, which go towards things like Live Strong and other sorts of great, you know, research. So as per the rules of Movember, you have to start, if you're going to grow a mustache for the whole month, you got to start fresh shaven. So tonight, October 31st, 2014, I am going to shave on the eve of Movember, like we always do.
Yep,
so.
And I'm going to shave after the video, but like I said, I can't grow facial hair.
He has nothing to shave.
Right. So, part of Movember, like Ryan said, is to raise funds, and the Zeta Kappa chapter of Alpha Sigma Phi in Whitewater, Wisconsin, which we are a member of, has raised $2,300 over the last 2 years. Now, we're hoping that we can continue to do this, but we want to make sure that your fundraising efforts are just as effective as ours have been, if not more so. So, Ryan and I believe that there is a plan to be successful in fundraising, and it's called the 3-4-5 plan. It means that there's 3 rules, right, Ryan?
3 golden rules.
4 steps and 5 tips. So, rule number 1 is if you don't ask, you shall not receive. That basically means if you don't ask someone for a donation, there's no way that they're ever going to give you one. So get out there, figure out who your donors are, and ask them for money. Rule number 2 is do not procrastinate. Do not wait till the end of November to ask for a donation.
End of Movember.
Movember. My apologies. On Movember 1st, you should be asking your first round of donors for donations. The sooner that you do it, the more donations you can accumulate, which means that you're not making up for it at the end. Rule number 3 is to have fun. This is the single manliest journey of your life. Why would you not take advantage of it and make sure that you're having as much fun with as we do, as you can see?
Yes, sir.
So now we're into the 4 steps. Number 1 is to know your why. As Ryan said, you know, men's health issues are extremely underfunded. It's something that's really close to us, being something that runs a little bit in Ryan's family as well as my own. Knowing your why is really important. So Figure out why you want to be part of Movember. The next step is to determine your target audience. So you want to make sure you're figuring out who your potential donors are. And let me give you some advice. Your best donors are not other individuals on your campus. College students don't have a lot of money. Your best audience is your family members. So ask your parents, ask your grandparents, ask your aunts and uncles, ask everyone in your family to make a donation. The next step is to ask. Like we said with the first rule, is if you don't ask, you shall not receive. So next step is to ask those people. So send a message to your parents. Send a text message right now to your parents asking them for a $50 donation. I bet you'll be surprised with their generosity and that'll get your Movember donation started. Step four is to thank your donors. So once they make a donation, you need to make sure that you send them a thank you message. Now, Movember's online platform is fantastic because it actually will auto-generate a thank you message for you, but you do want to make sure that you reach out to those people individually and thank them. So, now for the five tips. Think big is tip number one. You don't want to think about getting 10-cent donations from other students on campus.
You're not going to fix prostate cancer by collecting change in your local student center. No.
Exactly. Tip number two is you should not be afraid to share your goals with your potential donors. Don't be afraid to tell them that you want to raise $200 or $300 or whatever it might be. If the people that you're asking for donations for don't know what your goals are, they can't help you achieve them. Tip number three is donors give to those who give. So you want to make sure that you're starting off Movember by giving your own gift. It can be pretty small. Make a $5 donation to yourself, but making a gift to yourself will really help to generate more donations as the month goes on.
That's true.
Tip number four is to stay on track. Like we said at the beginning, you don't want to procrastinate, but you also want to make sure that you're keeping your pace, you're going through the month, and you're making donations consistently throughout it. And then tip number five is to utilize the resources that are provided for you already. Movember's online platform has tons. If you're in the Zeta Kappa chapter, which most of you probably are, you can certainly ask Ryan or I or Kyle Morris, who's been another top fundraiser for us, on some tips that they might have on how to do this. But utilize the resources that you have.
Kyle Morris might actually be the two-term back-to-back man of Movember.
Something like that. It's going to be really interesting to see if he can pull this off for a third year in a row.
Oh, we're going to make bets. We're going to make bets on you. Yeah. So, as we shave today, I just want to share with you that, number one, I was using a blade provided by Dollar Shave Club. If you haven't checked it out, feel free to. They literally gave us no money. I don't know why I'm sponsoring them right now. As well as Barbasol, my shaving cream of choice, who happens to be this year a proud sponsor of November and a major partner for all of their efforts. So, great. Cool. So, I don't know how we ended.
But... Fantastic. So, we're going to get the month started off the right way. We've shaved. We're going to start collecting donations. We hope that you help us out in raising as much money for men's health issues as possible so that we can change the face of men's health.
Yes.